Now, who do we bring in first? Fred, the elephant boy.
Yes, yes. Let's do that.
Okay, here we go. Hey, you're not a bad-looking guy at all. Sit down, Fred.
No, you're cute.
You got a little koala bear haircut. Here, get close to that microphone.
How you doing, Harvey?
Oh, man, it's the voice thing. You're not a bad looker. I know guys 10 times uglier than you.
You could get girls.
You have not gotten laid?
Never.
Unbelievable. It's the voice.
I don't see how that could be.
You know what it is? Your voice is too high. Can't you lower it? Go, ugh. Wait, let me put him on the harmonizer. Here, say something now.
I'm good, Harvey.
Wait a second.
Oh, yeah, that's real good, Harvey.
Why isn't that working? Where's my harmonizer? Okay, now try it.
Please,
no, it's not working. Harvey. No. Say it. Yeah. Hello, Tess. What is this radio station? What? I can't have a harmonizer work every day. I got to go through it. Now Scott's going to come in, that big, smelly, fat oaf, and try to fix it over my shoulder with that smelly breath. I tell him, put the harmonizer on, you moron.
Look, Scott's got a woman.
How does this guy not have a woman and Scott has a woman? Yeah. You're not a bad-looking guy.
That's how it is.
It's a lack of self-confidence. That's what it is.
Oh, man. Say this. Hi, honey. I got 50 bucks.
Hi, honey. I got 50 bucks.
Yeah, that should get you, girl.
They would jump in the car.
Yeah, I'm telling you. That's how I get my woman.
But here's... his mouth doesn't move over to the side.
No.
See?
I pictured you, like, with a hump in your back. And
I think that he could learn to talk correctly.
You're not putting me on, are you? No. Did you try to learn?
Yes. I took speech therapy throughout my life.
Oh, my God. They should all be fired. Talk about incompetence. You're kidding. I mean, you can't think. Like, you can say it like this. Ow.
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 And what can he use that sound for?
Say now, cow.
Oh.
Cow.
Oh, see, that was perfect.
There you go. Say a.
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 A. A.
Bay.
Bay.
See? Robin, imagine him if he hadn't taken speech therapy. Then we'd really have a great show. You're not a bad-looking guy.
Don't think we're talking Mel Gibson cute.
Oh, is that funny you just said that? I was going to say, he's no Mel Gibson, but...
But he's, you know, cute for an average guy.
Average. That's all I am.
Right. Whatever. And a doctor must tell you got some kind of thing going on.
It was from birth. Nothing
birth
they could
do.
Birth
did this to you.
Yeah, nothing they could do about it. Yeah.
Birth is maybe the largest reason for birth defects. And it's very bad birth.
Yes, we ought to stamp that out.
Who knows? Maybe they grabbed you around the neck or something when they pulled
There's
you out.
There's nothing wrong with your mouth.
Nothing.
It is perfectly formed.
Nothing. I've been to specialists, neurologists, and they find
it's
nothing.
It's not a muscle thing?
No, pop is not.
Maybe you're just dopey or something. You can't figure out how to talk. You know, it's possible. Who knows? I can't figure
this
one out.
Let's give him an IQ test right here. You got an IQ test?
You sure there's not a pair of forceps stuck on your tongue from birth? Maybe they left
it. The instruments are still there.
It's possible, you know, there, Fred. Well, you don't look half bad to me. And the reason
date him.
I'd date you. Well, maybe I wouldn't. I don't want to hear him talking like that around me all the time.
Well, he could be quiet. You're not real talkative, are you?
Yeah, if you go out with a girl, would you promise to keep your mouth shut? Just pay for stuff.
You know,
and then take off your clothes and do her. That's all right. There was women already calling in who wanted to sleep with you. Don't worry about it. I'm going to get your girls to sleep with. All right, the phones are a little slim right now, but they'll light up once we ask them to call in.
Because you're very bright, aren't you?
Yes, I am, Robin.
Okay, see there?
He's happening, got a job. More than most
like
guys out there.
I like his haircut.
Thank you, Robin.
I wouldn't cut my hair like that, but
it's
not bad.
You look quite yourself, not that I met you.
You know what you need? Excuse me about myself?
No, you look great. This is the first time I saw you. You look great.
Thank you. I got you. Just want to hear you say great a couple of times. As long as somebody's telling me I look great.
You might as well listen.
Well, you sound great. How's that? Okay. We're throwing around false compliments here.
No, you know, I have a neighbor who's absolutely hot over you.
Really?
Oh.
Who is that?
Well, I walk out of the house. Oh,
a guy or a girl?
So cute.
Really?
Yes.
Is she nice?
You have to bring... Very cute.
Oh, man.
You have to bring me a picture of him. Would you remind me to bring her a picture
of
you?
Yes. You're not kidding.
Because she's like, special... oh, he's so cute.
Oh, yes. I got to come over and visit you. What a haircut you got, Fred. Maybe the barber couldn't understand what you were talking about.
Didn't know what he was.
I don't have a little outro.
What? Oh, you want a lot off top?
No.
Oh, okay, whatever. Well, Fred, you certainly have a problem, but this is what we're going to do. I'm going to play some commercials now. Mm-hmm. When we come back from the commercials, I'm going to bring two Mother Teresas in here. Mother Bronski, we call them. We have Angel and Bim.
And Bim, yes.
These two girls want to come in. You know about this, right?
Yeah, I know.
You told me your fantasy is to have two women. These two girls, they both have D cup size.
Oh, fantastic.
Yes.
See, spit that out all right.
You know, I'm listening to you. Would you be willing to interview Carly Simon? Boy, what? Imagine we send him the next time. Oh man.
We're going to drive Carly back in any time now.
Man. But let me ask you this, Fred. As a matter of fact, we'll be happy to know that our special guest, Fred, today will also, with his help, after the show, will be starring in a movie.
Oh, we're going to make a movie star.
Fred, that's Quentin the Stutterer, and the Tourette's Girl are all going to be in a new Christmas Carol for our Christmas show come December.
And a Christmas Carol.
Yep, and you play the, I won't give away too much, but you play the ghost of speech impediment Pat. It's beautiful. And, of course, we'd be honored if you'd like to make your acting debut.
Oh, my mind.
Oh, yes. Okay.
Well, you know you've got to get married, Fred, because you need somebody to take care of your lovely mother and the mother of your children.
Yeah, you got to get married because no one's going to date you.
For a long time.
Right.
No,
we're going to get you a girl. We're going to get the girl for you. Mm-hmm. It's going to happen. You have never even seen breasts live, right?
No.
Wow.
Not since infancy.
You've never even touched them, right?
I never.
Well.
Let me see those hands. Are they shaking?
No, Fred, you are 5 minutes away from your first sexual experience.
Ooh!
With Angel and Bim.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, all right. Just calm down, will you, Fred? God's sakes, you look like your head's going to explode.
Yeah, can somebody sit on him?
Yeah. Jackie, sit on him. All right, so, you gotta lose those glasses, though.
Yeah, it's a little dirty.
It's a little what?
You know, it's a little, maybe a little smear.
No, lose the glasses. Don't take them off. Oh, I mean, just get sunglasses or something.
Maybe, yeah.
What, do you want him to act like he's blind, too?
Yeah, the dog. Walk around with a dog and dark glasses. Stevie Wonder gets laid. Well, anyway, of course, you know, You've got a wonderful personality. It's just nobody can understand it. That's the only problem.
You're a sweetheart. I think you're a very sweet person, aren't you?
Then you date him, Robin.
Oh, stop.
Well, she's a big star. She can't. You got to speak normal for her. But there are plenty of women who would like you. Number one, you got a good job. Number two, you're a nice guy. And number three.
What are women looking for?
There is no number three. Well, whatever.
No, but what do they say? They want a nice man.
Yeah.
A man who has a job.
I'm sensitive.
He's thin.
Sensitive.
Yeah. You got a nice body. Got a big one?
He's got all the body.
You got a big one?
Average size.
You know what I'm saying?
No. Average size.
Average size. Yeah. Figures. Boy, God is cruel.
Average is good. What are you talking about?
He should at least have a large one, for God's sake. Well, anyway, let's get the two girls in here. The two angels who want to meet you. The two angels who heard that you had never had any sexual contact your entire 30 years of life, that you remain a virgin, that you have not even been kissed by a girl, am I correct?
No. No.
What?
You know, that's a sin.
Oh, that's a sin.
That this man has gone this long.
Maybe on the cheek, but nothing sensual. Nothing sensual. Just a greetings kiss.
Like ants and stuff.
Yeah, you go. Yeah.
Now, here's the girls. Oh, that must be Bim. That's not Bim?
Bim couldn't make it?
What happened to Bim? Wow, look at your breasts. Oh, God, this is great. Are you excited, Fred?
This must be Angel.
Oh, yes, I am, Howie.
That's right. Now, Angel?
Yeah, hi.
I met Angel before.
That's right. How you doing, Howie?
Oh, yeah, you met her at Roosevelt Field?
Yeah, I have to do that again very soon. I have to get over to Roosevelt Field. There's going to be more girls like Angel. Angel, you're a very beautiful girl. I'm going to tell you that right now. You're a little hefty. I'm going to say that.
Yeah.
But I'm going to tell you something. You got a nice face, and your breasts are what?
44D.
Fred, do you love that?
Oh, my goodness. I'm in Trimland.
I thought you said Trimland.
No, stop it.
Oh, okay.
Fred doesn't talk like that. You talk like that.
Who knows what Fred talks like? Now, let the girls, here. Now, wait a second. Now, Angel, who's your friend?
This is my friend Jackie.
Jackie.
What?
Take a good look at Fred. This is not a bad-looking guy. Am I right?
Come here and speak.
Yeah, he's a 7 out of 10.
He's a 7 out of 10.
I accept that.
That's above average.
Yeah, I accept that.
That's right. Don't punch him.
They want to beat him up already.
Jackie, punch him. Calm down, Jackie. This is a fragile guy. Now, understand that Fred has never even been kissed by a girl because of his speech impediment. You got to admit, the speech impediment sounds a little goofy, okay, but he's still not that bad, right?
Not bad at all.
You know, if you really thought about it, Woody Allen doesn't talk all that great.
No. He's sort of wormy sounding. Well, anyway, so Jackie, now you two are a motorcycle girl? I noticed you're wearing Harley Davidson clothes and...
Maybe they could get you those boots.
Wearing a ladies' motorcycle club leather and lace.
Oh, I've read about one. Oh,
yeah. Fred, what'd you expect, okay? He's also, I don't know about that. Are you excited?
You think
the girls are nice looking? I think.
They're great looking.
They really are. Now, Jackie, you have no problem taking your top off and Bronskiing Fred here?
Oh, well, my husband wants you to call him.
Well.
Ask him if it's okay.
Well, come on. I can't call your husband. I don't have time for that. I got to get dates. There's always stipulations.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's okay. I assume if you're here, it's okay. Mm. Now, Jackie, your breasts are very beautiful as well. What size are they? Tell everyone, please.
Coming around to talk to you.
38D.
38D. You got to be so proud.
They're experienced because she's married.
That's right. Those are experienced breasts. Fred, you nervous at all about this?
No, I'm a bit little, yeah.
Now, girls, what exactly? You going to take your shirts off and let him Bronski?
Oh, we're going to take care of Fred in a way he's never been taken care of.
Wow.
Really? Well, let's find out. Fred, this is your... Look at Fred. He's a little nervous. Fred, this is the first... How long have you been dreaming about this, Fred?
Ever since you called me.
Wow.
Yeah, he's been dreaming nonstop with his eyes open, eyes closed.
I mean, this is exciting for you. Yes. All right, and then we'll get to the date. Because there's many women who want to meet you. Now, you tell the girls out there in our audience, isn't this guy's okay, right?
He's not bad looking at all.
Not bad. You've seen worse.
You much sling worse. Him on the back of your bike, wouldn't you?
Hey, I'd sling almost anybody on the back of my bike.
Angel, would you have sex with this guy? Well, you're going to, so I guess you would. Oh, there you go.
Hold on, I'll give him my number right after the show. We'll
hey, you two girls, hell with him. What about me giving you a little bronze? No, okay. No, absolutely, this is Fred's day.
This is a charity.
Hey, Fred, right. How do you feel about tattoos?
Well, it doesn't matter.
Okay, you said it.
Beggars can't be choosers. Now, what are you tattooing all over your body, Angel?
You're going to be in shock, Howard.
I really am. But what about...
Really? What is this?
And what about Jackie, though? Are you tattooed all over your body, too?
Oh, well.
You have a few?
A few.
All right. Well.
We'll see.
Fred, I guess, is going to be forced to
I
like
don't think
it.
He's going to see real flesh, but he'll be okay.
If you can find those breasts, go ahead.
It'll be fake
flesh. All right, girls, go ahead. Come on, let's Bronski.
Let's
all right, I'll do the play-by-play. Play. The girls are standing up. Their headphones are coming off. Gary, get out of here. Wow, your breasts are so big. Oh, my God. Now, you're taking off your tops. Is that it?
Well, the tops are coming off.
Fred's headphones are coming off. Jackie's shirt is coming off. Well,
oh, my goodness.
Fred's glasses have just been pulled off. Fred, keep that microphone close to you. Now, Fred is excited. Now, Jackie, what about you? Is your shirt coming off?
There
it goes. Wow. They're getting double Bronski all over his face.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Look at the size of those. Fred, unbelievable. Wow. Close that door, John. What's wrong with you? Stuttering John, of course. Wow. Where the hell's Jackie in all this?
Good. Where's Fred? I can't see him.
Fred is having a great time. That's it, Fred. Oh, that's marvelous. Marvelous, girls. Oh, Jackie, this had that many tattoos. What is that, a motorcycle on your one breast? And a...
This is a wheel.
A wheel of a motorcycle on your breast.
A winged wheel. A winged whale, I said. And,
hey, Jackie's excited, and so is Angel.
My hands are numb.
Fred, mumble encore. You might get lucky.
I mean, is there anything you would like to do, Fred? I mean,
Fred, was that a good experience for you?
Oh, fantastic.
Really? You like that, huh?
I wish I brought my pecker meter.
Hey, easy, honey.
Sorry, honey.
Calm down there.
Fred was putting his arms around the girls.
Yeah.
I didn't see anything.
I saw plenty. I saw too much. Fred, you looked really happy.
Oh, I was.
What?
Oh, sorry. Can I say something personal? Rick, it was great.
It was great.
Yeah.
Yes. A little personal message to Rick.
I see.
I think. Well, girls, that was fun for you, huh?
Yeah, it was.
Oh. Jackie, you were a little timid there. Your top did come off, but it was. You seemed a little nervous.
Yeah,
is that right?
Okay.
Everybody's lighting up their cigarettes having after-sex cigarettes.
It was six, Howard. It was six.
Fred, how are you feeling? Are you thinking about what just happened? Well, what did you think of breasts?
You know, he took one last look before Angel pulled her top back up because he doesn't know when he's going to see breasts again.
All right, we got a break for spots. When we come back, Fred's big date. Now, girls, this is your chance to call in. I'm telling you, now here's the positives. The two girls sitting here, and Robin said he's good-looking.
Yeah. He's had one sexual experience.
That's all. So he's totally clean.
We'll vouch for him.
All right. I'm surprised you girls didn't get more into it with him. I'm surprised that the moment didn't get carried away and all of a sudden you were going wild. But that was interesting. That was interesting. I thought for a second there was going to be actual lovemaking in the studio.
Well, we got certain standards to uphold.
That's right. I understand that. Of course.
Hey, we got as low as we can go, you know.
You know, girls, I have an idea before we say goodbye to you and let Fred have his dial a date. Is it possible to take some ice cream, rub it on your breast?
Oh, no.
And have Fred lick it off?
Oh,
is it possible, Angel? I mean, to make that happen for Fred?
Yeah, why not?
Oh. She likes ice cream.
All right.
What flavor would you like? This is such great ice cream.
Why don't you try the apple crisp?
Why don't we try it? And then, Fred, you could tell us how the apple crisp tastes.
Yeah, I'll be the fish test tester.
Whatever.
What he said.
What he said. Whatever you say.
Yeah, right.
You taste it, and then, right, official taste tester.
Yeah.
And there's Philadelphia vanilla coffee with Heath candy bar. All right. Now, what is that? That's, what flavor is that, Gary?
This is the Big Apple Crisp.
Oh, great. Now, Fred, don't taste it the conventional way. Angel, what are you going to do? You going to rub some of this on your breast?
I'll put it right in between the
bed. All right, go ahead.
Whoa!
Very good. Angel's such a party girl. I like Angel. She's a real Mother Teresa.
Yes,
here's
she
a guy.
Is.
She heard his plea, and she showed up. You're going to heaven. You
oh
know that,
my
Angel.
Goodness. This is it. She's going to take the ice cream.
All right, her shirt is
Fred
off.
Fred is going to put the ice cream between her breasts.
Smear it on with your hand, for God's sakes, Fred.
Oh,
he's smearing it on with a spoon. Now, Fred, go ahead. Take a taste.
Oh, yeah.
I think he's done this before. Look at this. Whoa! He's digging it. Whoa! He's eating dinner. Oh, man. Easy, Fred.
What did he put on her? A pint?
I'm going to hell. All right, Fred. Now, tell me, what do you think?
It tastes delicious.
Yeah, it does, huh? The breast money can buy. How'd that taste, by the way?
Good? Yeah, it tastes good.
Yeah, he knew what he was doing. Totally unconscious. Now, you know, Fred, what kind of girl are you looking for? One that breathes?
Oh,
yes.
That's a prerequisite.
Oh, you're so picky, though, you know?
What?
A prerequisite.
Yeah.
Is your zipper welded shut by now? I see you could hardly stand up.
Thank goodness he wore loose pants.
Yeah. No, you got to admit your hero is Howard Stern now.
You got it.
Damn right.
You didn't tell your mother to listen to this program.
She says, we all suck.
She said we all suck?
No, she would be so shocked.
Oh, she would be so shocked. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Hell with her. She's
she
just an old,
her son.
She's just an old lady.
Having sex?
Yeah, why should a 30-year-old man have some breasts finally? If she was a decent mother, she would have done it for
him. Stop it.
No.
Yeah, that's true. Fred, you got to stop being afraid of your mother. Now, if you get a girl and you decide to get married, would you leave your mother's house?
Oh, she wants me to have my own apartment.
Yeah.
So.
Now, why have you stopped? Why? What has stopped you from getting your own apartment?
It's the economy. It's very expensive to live where I
live. I see.
But maybe with two, you know, it may be a little bit better.
Right. Sure, I know what he said. All right, but who has time to have him repeat it? I really, who cares why he's living with his mother? Yeah. The point is, we're here to get you a girl.
Well, now, where are you going to take a girl if you get one, Fred?
We desire something. You know.
I'm hoping the girls out there realize, and you know, when you hear Fred's voice, you're going, well, okay, man, he's a good-looking guy. He's a nice-looking guy.
He's a cute guy, and I know there's nothing wrong with him the way he went after those breasts.
Yeah.
I can tell.
He's heterosexual. Let's tantalize the babes. What are you packing? Tell him. 7, 8?
It's ever
eight.
Slight. I never
he just said eight.
Message.
Now, where would you like to take a girl on a fantasy date?
Yeah, probably to sometimes dance club. I like to dance.
Dance a little bit?
Yeah.
Ooh,
no.
Put on some music, Howard.
He doesn't want to dance right now, Rob. Well, let's just hope you go somewhere where you don't have to ask for directions. Because you'll never get there. All right, let's get to the phones. If you ask for directions, you'll be there all night. Now, we've got our New York, our Philly, and Washington lines.
What are you've thought about a girl you might like. What would she be like?
I thought pretty. I want a nice girl, you know, with not a boo who enjoys life. I'm not personality. That's all I ask for.
All right. What Fred just said is he wants someone young, attractive, and they must have most of their limbs. All right? All right.
Most, not all. Not he's all. Not picky.
Hello?
Hi.
Hi.
I'm calling to dial a date.
Okay, what's wrong with you?
What's wrong with me?
No, of course I'm kidding. No, now, this is a nice, I'm telling you, I swear to God, this is a nice looking guy, yeah. Normal intelligence. Probably people think you're not smart because you don't speak so good, right?
No, I'm very smart. I always have above average IQ.
Right. Yeah. And the guy, I'm telling you, after you talk to him for a while, you sort of start to understand him.
You're talking to him in there on the breaks.
I don't know what he said. He said something about being happy. I don't know. All right, now, what about you? Are you an attractive girl?
Yeah, I'm a go-go dancer.
Oh, you're a go-go dancer?
Oh, go-go
dancer. Wait a second, I would let her play, Fred. How old are you?
33.
33 and a go-go dancer? Got a good body?
Yeah.
And you think that if you are attracted to Fred a little bit, there could be a sexual opportunity there? I gotta be honest with you. This guy's 30 years old. He's a virgin, and the only reason he's
I've been married three times. I can handle it.
Okay, good. Because the
so
only reason
you know what you're doing.
I swear to you, the only reason he's a virgin is because of the boys thing.
That's no problem.
Because I'm looking at him. Believe me.
He's probably a little shy too.
Yeah. And I think you'll be able to understand him.
Oh, sure I will.
I'm sort of understanding him.
Yeah?
Although I'm not even sure he's at the right radio station. He should be a different guy. I don't know what he's doing.
I've been listening to you all week. He's cool.
He's cool, right?
Oh, yeah.
All right, and you're a go-go dancer in a bar?
Yeah.
Oh, great. Okay, hold on.
I've been doing it for 8 years.
Oh, hold on.
Okay.
All right. Oh, they got great bodies.
Well, I was going to ask, she's been doing it for 8 years. Is she doing, like, the flash dance kind of go-go dancing?
I don't know. You doing a flash dance or you know, with your top on, or you do topless?
Whatever.
Really? So you do topless, huh?
Huh?
Topless dancing?
Whatever's legal here.
Okay, hold on.
Okay.
She carries a law book around with her.
She's also a part-time lawyer. Fred?
Yeah.
I think you're gonna get laid.
Well, you just calm down. Date, okay?
Hold it. Hello?
Hi, Howard.
Oh, this is Celeste.
I guess. True. Yay.
Hey, this is a guarantee. Do you know Celeste? Have you heard her, Fred?
Yeah, I'm in Maple Hall.
This is the one who went out with Darren.
What?
All right, now I could even show you a picture of her.
Good.
And she took Darren, who you are 10 times better looking than. No offense to Darren, but isn't he better looking than Darren?
Definitely.
Oh, God, I hope so.
And he just at least talks, even though you don't understand him.
He has a personality. Darren has not.
She got him in bed and got him down to his underwear. He didn't want to do anything, but you could do it. This is guaranteed.
She'll take you home.
She'll take you home. You want to play with her?
Yeah, put it on.
Okay.
Ooh, you're on hold. I never thought you were like this.
Oh, he wants it. This is a 30-year-old guy, Robin.
Dad.
You got the go-go dancer, Celeste. Now, Celeste drags her foot a little bit.
She's a grandmother.
She is not.
She is, too.
She is a grandmother?
Yeah.
Celeste, you're a grandmother?
No, I'm not a grandmother.
Oh, you're just a mother. Okay, hold on. She's not
she
that bad.
She looks like a grandmother. No.
I mean, the picture I saw, of course, I didn't see her dragging her leg behind her. But the picture I saw, she was not that bad. In fact, I think we even might have a picture of her around the office.
Yeah, her walker's in the corner in that picture.
No, as a matter of fact, we do have a picture of her and Darren on their date.
That's
on my
true.
Wall.
She's not that bad.
All right, so I can show you a picture of her. Okay. And let's get you one more girl. She's a grandmother. Like, that would stop this guy. This guy would hump a great-grandmother. Hello?
Hello?
Hello? There's a guy. That's a great-grandmother.
Howard?
Yes? You want to play?
Yeah.
You good-looking girl?
Yeah, definitely.
You don't mind the sound of Fred's voice?
No.
How old are you?
Well, I was 22 last week.
Ah.
22? Yeah. How old are you, Fred?
I'm 30.
You
perfect.
Like him young?
Yeah.
Of course he likes him young. Head's ready to explode over there. Yeah, anything wrong with you?
Absolutely not.
Yeah, okay. You want to let her play?
Yeah, she sounds okay.
Yeah, what do you do for a living?
Well, I'm unemployed. I'm a student, really.
You like to sleep with guys?
Well, I'm not really experienced, but...
You've never had a guy?
Well, you know.
You've never had sex?
Well...
Make up your mind.
Yeah, I have, but...
But what?
I'm looking for the right guy, you know?
You're looking for the right... Sounds like you already found the wrong guy, but you had sex with him.
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Now you're being particular.
You might have to work this one a bit, Fred. Mm. I can't
But
guarantee.
You could get a relationship out of this.
Yeah, she sounds like she might be kind of homely, but...
No, what do you look like?
No, definitely not homely.
Who do you look like?
Well, I'm very tall.
All right, you can play. Hold on. Okay. All right, we got our three girls. Let me take a break. All right, let's get to the girls. It's time for Dial-A-Date. Fred's here. And Fred, you can feel free to jump in and ask the girls questions.
Yeah.
Don't let me burst your bubble. It's important that you like the girls. Diane?
Yeah.
This is Diane, the go-go dancer.
Right.
33-year-old go-go dancer. Now, how'd you get into go-go dancing?
For the money.
For the money?
Yeah.
What were you, like a single girl? You were how old when you got into this? 23? 25.
Yeah. Yeah.
You're pretty agreeable to any age.
That's her story.
I was married and my ex-husband didn't work. He was a musician. And he had two kids, so that's a story.
Oh, you had two kids?
He did.
Oh, he had two kids.
Oh, and you had to go out and work?
Yeah.
To support his kids?
Yeah.
Cool.
Oh,
man, what a liberated woman.
Were you guys heroin addicts and everything?
No. We were too poor to do drugs.
I see. Now, you say you're very beautiful.
Yeah, I guess.
Now, when's the last time you were with a man?
What time is it? Is that the question you want to
ask? I don't want to answer.
You mean you're
that.
With a man right now? You're having sex right now?
Yeah.
You're in the middle of having sex. Is there a man there now?
No, huh?
Oh, there is.
No, there's not.
Oh, I see. Now, when's the last time you had a date?
I don't know.
You don't know when you had a date?
I can't answer that.
Wait a minute. Are you in a relationship right now?
Maybe, yeah.
Oh, is there a guy?
There's a couple of guys.
Now, how are you going to... But nobody knows who you are, so you can answer these questions.
Who knows who might be listening?
Well, why'd you call?
Yeah, don't you have enough men?
I want to go out with Fred.
You do like Fred.
I can have a good time, yeah.
You want to have a good time with Fred?
Yeah.
And you're a pretty loose girl. I mean, you don't play any games.
No. I've been wanting to come down there, too, because all these things that you want these girls to do and they come down and they don't do it,
yeah.
I'll do it.
Oh, you would do it?
Oh, yeah.
Hmm. I'm kidding. Fred, you want my strategy on this?
Oh, boy.
I think, yeah.
Talk to all three girls.
Yeah.
And then nail the old lady.
I don't look my age.
Are you sure you're going to...
I'll send you a poster. I don't look my age.
Yeah, well, you ought to come down now.
Who do you look like?
Who do I look like?
Yeah.
Let me see. I look like a blonde Pat Benatar.
Pat Benatar?
Mm-hmm.
And you got a great body like that? How much do you weigh?
About 110.
110? And
you said you're very tall?
No, I'm not tall.
Oh, you're not tall.
That's number three.
5'3".
I see. And your cup size?
I don't know. I think it's a B.
A B.
Yeah, I don't have very big breasts.
I see. Well,
that's. I got buns.
The hell with this speech. Hell with this speech impediment guy. Want to ride in my limo today?
Yeah.
See.
Let's go, baby.
Sorry,
I'll be on my knees and won't be praying.
Whoa.
All right. Now, okay. Well, Fred, this sounds like a really loose girl. Now, you must have started having sex at a very young age.
Yeah.
How old were you?
14.
14. Now, who was this lucky guy that met you at 14?
He had a speech impediment now.
Now, how did you meet? I mean, what happened? How
he was
old
17.
Was, how old was the guy?
17.
17?
Yeah, he was always playing with himself all the time.
Well, take it easy here, will you? Just calm down. Sort of like Fred? Fred, you don't do anything.
No. Fred has class.
Yeah, thank you.
Now, what is it about Fred that turns you on? What is it about Fred?
He's a gentleman.
You like
her. Yeah, she hasn't had that yet. I don't know.
I got a feeling that she has not had too many gentlemen. I have a feeling she might have been with some women as well. Am I right?
No.
Yeah, come on.
No.
Something once might have happened.
One queer in the family is enough.
One queer in the family?
Yeah.
Is there a queer in your family?
Yeah.
Well, I don't like that word.
My brother's probably listening.
Oh, you mean your brother's gay?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Whatever.
Well, just think, when he brings her home to his mother.
Yeah. I wonder what she brings home to her mother. And I wonder what her brother brings home to the mother.
Yeah, that's a good question.
And I wonder why the mother doesn't just shoot herself.
Did a pretty good job.
That's
now, so you dance in these bars and you take your shirt off?
Whatever's legal.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And have you ever, on this date, you couldn't bring another girlfriend with you to have Fred really go nuts?
Oh, sure.
Oh, you could.
I could probably arrange that, yeah.
So you've been in situations like this where a guy wants two women. Haven't you?
Possibly.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
And that has happened.
Yeah.
I see. Robin, that sounds to me like something. Now, tell me about this. When was the first time that ever happened?
That was a long time ago.
Oh, yeah? What happened?
I don't know.
Your boyfriend?
Well, this derelict husband of hers wanted to.
Did your husband want...
No, it's like women come on to me. I don't know why.
Women come on to you all the time?
Yeah.
Well, maybe because you take your shirt off a lot in public.
Maybe
they get the wrong idea.
Those butchy kind like me.
I see.
And what are you? Feminine.
You're very feminine, and you probably wear very short dresses all the time.
Yeah,
do they
like
hang
leather.
Around the topless bars? These butchy
Oh, they do. So what happened? One of these butchy women were hanging around.
They come in the bathroom and try and, you know.
And try and pick you up.
Yeah.
I see. So what happens, officer? How did you end up with two girls and one guy?
Oh, God, I don't remember. That was a long time
ago. How did that happen? What, did you have a
husband? It was like at an after-hours club or some shit like that.
No, whoa.
Oh,
hold on. You can't say the S word.
I'm sorry.
You're a fascinating young woman, but you can't use the S word.
Remember your finishing school.
Yes.
Sorry.
Didn't you go to finishing school?
No.
Did you go to high school? Did you graduate high school?
Yeah, I went to college.
This is Mayflower Madam. What are you talking
about? I see. You went to college, and you ever accept money for sex?
No.
Mm-hmm.
No, sir.
They couldn't get it out fast enough.
Now, have you ever been with two guys at the same time? Well, what's with
what?
You?
Is that too low a number? What is
have you been with five guys at the same time?
No.
No? Two guys at the same time? So you have been, haven't you?
Yeah.
Now, how did that happen? You don't remember that either?
Question.
No, really, what happened? You were hanging around at, what, a party?
Yeah, after hours club.
After what?
After hours. This was down south.
Oh, you were in an after-hours club.
Yeah.
And you're hanging around, what, with your boyfriend?
No, just some guys.
Some guys picked you up?
Yeah.
Would you say this was your wildest experience ever? I feel like I'm at the head of Nussbaum trial, like I'm a lawyer or something. Honey, you got to loosen up and talk to me
what?
Here.
What?
Stop sweating. What, are you naked right now?
Yeah.
Oh, you're in bed naked?
No, I'm standing up.
You're standing up in bed naked.
Get down. You're going to hurt yourself.
You're going to ruin the bed. You're going to bang your head on the ceiling. So you're a young Pat Benatar with blonde hair. You dance a lot, and you ended up in bed with two guys.
Yeah.
But we can't quite figure out how. You're at an after-hours club.
Yeah.
And you're hanging around with a bunch of new guys, right?
Well, one of them I knew. One of them I didn't.
I see. And what, they say, hey, let's go somewhere?
Nah, they kind of like, hey, let's go back and have a few drinks and then, if my friend comes along.
I see. So you thought that was you were kind of drunk.
Yeah, well, it kind of went over my head.
I see. So you went back where? In the back room of the After Hours Club?
No, we went back to somebody's house.
Oh, somebody's house. So it was just you and the two guys.
Yeah, and I sort of like just passed out.
Oh, you passed out.
She sort of reminds me of that character that, what's her name, played in The Accused.
Yeah, Jodie Foster. She tells me Jodie Foster passed out.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
But, and were you in the club wearing like a mini skirt and dress
versa?
I see.
Or something like spandex pants or something. Shorts.
I see. Some shorts.
Mm, yeah.
You like to dress like that, huh?
Huh?
You like to wear a cowboy hat and easy Fred.
Leather.
Fred's like,
I'm into leather.
Fred, you digging her?
She's so nice.
All right, we got to take a break. You hold on there. Your name is Diane, right? Diane, is there anything sexy you want to say to Fred to make him pick you?
Nah, just be yourself, Fred.
Okay.
Well, you certainly have been. All right, hold on.
Okay.
Do you have a nickname, Diane, that anybody likes to call you?
Easy.
Is Easy your nickname?
No.
No. All right, hold on.
Okay.
Well, that's Diane. Listen, Hal, you're going to...
Oh, boy.
You think she's good. Wait till you hear number two. She's just going to say, I'll sleep with him, period. That's it.
Okay.
Right, just calm down now, Fred. You feeling a little more confident now?
Oh, yes. Yes, Howard.
Yes. See, it's just a matter of finding you the right girl and marketing you, presenting you in the right light.
Yeah.
See, this girl wants to jump. She'll appreciate you, Fred.
That's it. Like I said.
On the day, try not to wear that shirt, okay? Try to wear something.
Oh, he's huge.
All right, take it easy. Just calm down, Fred. I didn't mean that. All right, now we'll be back right after these words. You know who Fred looks like? Have you watched that new MTV show?
Which? Mouth to Mouth?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The talk show?
Yes.
Fred looks like the host of that show.
He does.
Yep. You look like the host of that show.
I do.
Don't thank us. That's not a compliment.
No, it's not bad. I mean, it's just you're a nice looking guy.
It's okay. I'll watch it.
Okay, take it easy. All right, this is Celeste. She's played before. You always get through.
Hi, Howard. I love getting through to you.
Oh, there's the voice. And you hear that voice and you go, yeah.
Hi, Robin, and hi, Fred.
How's it, Ash?
How are you?
Oh, I'm fine.
Oh, talk to her in your sexy voice, Fred.
Yeah, you put on your voice.
You talk much better.
I feel great.
What'd he say?
I feel great.
Oh, you feel great.
You feel
okay.
Great. I don't blame you.
So, Celeste, I'm going to cut through all the bull. You will sleep with this guy, won't you?
Sure, I will. I slept with Darren, didn't I?
Well, that didn't work out too well.
I know.
That was Darren's fault.
Yeah, but Celeste...
Darren also wrote a love letter to Fred, so that's why that didn't work out.
No, but he swears he's into women. He swears. But the point is, I've seen the picture of Celeste.
Why didn't you bring it into,
Gary, can you, I've only asked Gary 900 times for that picture, but he's very busy outside, just hanging around with different people.
Oh, I see.
He's a good, he's a great guy to hang out with.
He is a hanger around.
Yeah, because he has no job responsibility, so he can just hang around all day, unencumbered by the rush of work. But, Celeste.
Yes.
Now, this guy is better looking than Darren.
Yes.
That couldn't be worse.
Right.
And you hear he has a better personality.
Gotta have one.
And he has a good personality. And the thing is, the speech impediment thing doesn't upset you.
No.
So it's a pretty much a guaranteed thing that you're going to hop into bed with him.
How tall is he?
How tall are you?
Oh, I'm about 5'10".
5'10".
Yeah.
Fine.
And he's thin, and he's got a nice physique.
Yeah. Huh. And you like young men.
Yeah.
I love young men.
That's right. And how old are you again?
40.
No, not you, Celeste. I mean,
I'm 30.
You're 40 also.
No, 30. 30.
3 years old, okay. Whatever. So, she's a writer, which means actually that she has a diary that she writes down things.
And she writes us letters. Yeah. That's basically what it means.
She writes us annoying postcards all the time.
No,
giving
Howard,
me instructions.
Howard, you called me a bitch on the air.
Okay. Oh, here's her picture. This is her. This is who we're talking about, Fred. Now, what do you think of her?
The one on the left or the right?
The one on the left. The one on the right is the guy, Darren.
Oh, dear.
You recognize the difference. Oh, Seth, you look lovely. Yeah.
But Darren looks you look better.
You were only
Darren
kidding.
Better, right?
I thought Darren was a female.
You did? Oh, man. Okay. Fred, are you blind or...
He hasn't had a woman in that long. Darren looked like a woman.
He was ready to date Darren. He was like, yeah, the one on the right isn't bad.
I wasn't sure, but the one on the right. I know the one on the left was a lady.
Yes, well, she's the one on the left. She's not bad.
No, she's not. She's...
And you're guaranteed, I mean, she took this guy into bed and had him naked in 5 minutes after they listened to tapes of the show.
Oh, she gets hot over the show.
Hey, Celeste, what about you? What's the wildest place you ever had sex?
Oh, the revolving door at the Barbizon Hotel for women.
And she was by herself.
Yeah. Well, that door is really giving you some good action.
No, I was with somebody.
She's a tough contestant because every guy says, well, okay, I could definitely get it on here.
Yeah, but you could definitely, well, number one is a definite, too.
Yeah, that sounded pretty definite.
Yeah, but I'm more definite than her.
You are. You mean it is guaranteed.
I'm already a proven fact.
Hold on 1 second. Number one, are you a guaranteed thing that you will sleep with?
Sure.
Oh, okay, hold on.
And look, you got a dancer's body there you're talking to.
That's true.
Or a dragging leg.
Yeah, that's true. This is tough today. You got one woman who drags your leg, and you got the other one with a dancer's body, who's a little bit younger. But we know this one is not telling a lie. I know for a fact this one will take him to bed.
I believe number one.
So, you will drag him into bed like you drag your leg.
Yes.
What is that whole dragging the leg thing?
She had a stroke.
Was that what it was?
No,
what happened?
A car accident.
Oh, that's no big deal. Big deal, right, Fred?
Big deal, but it's not a big deal with a leg.
All right. Now, hold on, okay?
Okay.
That's Celeste, the writer. All of a sudden, she's a writer now. That's she's listing her occupation. Hasn't sold anything.
It used to be Celeste who'll sleep with anyone. Now it's Celeste, the writer.
Who will write about sleeping with anyone. Well, I'll tell you something, Celeste. You're a very giving woman because, sight unseen, you're willing to sleep with Fred here, and that's very, very beautiful.
I mean, even after she saw Darren, she took him to bed.
That's right. So there you go. And I know Fred and Darren, I mean, you know, Fred, I think, is a little bit better looking than
Darren. Yeah, I think so.
A lot better looking.
Oh, good. Please say. Don't say I think.
All right, listen.
We'll see anybody's
we still have a bachelorette number three, Celeste, so let me put you on hold.
Okay.
We know your whole story.
Okay.
Right, hold on.
Every time we talk to this woman, we get a different story.
I'll tell you, they're all fascinating. What do you think of her, Fred?
Oh, she's lovely also.
Yeah, okay.
Go to bed after this is in.
Oh, just wait till you hear number three.
Yeah, that's right.
Give her a chance.
Who's never done anything and won't do anything.
Yeah. Oh, she has a good chance. Yeah, okay. We'll be back with 30-year-old virgin Fred. For obvious reasons. All right, now. He's such a nice guy, too.
He is.
Well, anyway, let's talk about, you know, if you're, you know, my voice sounds so deep today next to Fred's. Let me hear you on the deep voice. Let me try this one last time. Go ahead.
Howard, let's hear bachelorette number three after the break.
See, you gotta get that deep voice thing going. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, listen to him now.
Yeah. What should I say?
Anything you say sounds better.
Jackie, do me a favor. Draw a dot on Fred's forehead and we'll pass him off as some kind of Indian with a wacky accent. Walk around in a robe. So you need new packaging, that's all. Okay, now you sound kind of manly. Fred, now you sound kind of manly. Doesn't he, Robin?
He does.
Yeah. Ain't not gonna take aim, babe.
Right. Robin, actually, you sound more manly than he does.
No. That's not true.
Yeah, well, anyway, can a speech teacher teach him to get his voice a little deeper?
I think exercises would help.
Well, like barbells?
On his tongue.
I see. What do you think? It's a tongue thing with him that he speaks this way?
I don't know. I'm watching him, but I can't really see him when he's talking.
Yeah. No, I can see him. I don't see a thing.
Maybe that's it. He doesn't move his tongue.
You know, Fred, a good speech teacher would teach you to shut the hell up. Don't you agree, Robin?
Yes. Stick to yes and no.
Go over
Let's
there.
Try those two words.
You do a couple of warm-up exercises, and then you just keep your mouth shut the rest of the day. Well, anyway, the point is that is great. Because they have everything you'd want in lumber, paint, hardware, electrical supplies, plumbing, wall coverings, housewares, floor coverings, furnishings, patio furnishing, gardening, landscaping, and more. And they have it all. And hi, this is Bob Ray and our brother that we keep in a closet.
Hi, Bob. Hi, Ray.
Oh, boy. Anyway, you can pick up a weatherproof weather stripping, whatever the hell that is. It's sale priced at only $1.49.
Well, winter is coming.
Bob and Ray would actually know what that's about.
Yeah, you gotta insulate.
That's right. Because when we get our babes in the house, we like to keep the place warm.
That's right.
You betcha, I'm telling you. In fact, you know what I'm doing this winter?
What are you doing?
I'm going to get some of that frosting, weatherproof, weather stripping.
Yeah.
Put it up on the house. And then I'm going to build a giant sled from all of the Rickle lumber.
Right.
To carry my huge genitals in the snow. I'm telling you. Because they're really heavy in the snow. And I'm going to keep them like on a sled. What are you going to do for yours, Ray?
I'm going to put skis on a wheelbarrow.
I see. You know, Ray, you laugh a lot like Robin.
I know. That's one of the drawbacks of being me.
I understand.
I never like to laugh when I'm around women.
Yeah, you shouldn't.
Because I laugh like a woman.
Yeah. You gotta watch. I'm sort of wondering about you. What are you going to do with your huge genitals, Fred?
Who knows?
You're not much of an ad libber either, are you? No, you're not. I think your genitals dried up. You know what I mean? You haven't used them in 30 years, pal. Hard to believe. I can't believe you couldn't get one woman, man.
I figured another problem he has.
Yeah.
He's been hanging around with regular guys.
Yeah, you could hang around with real men like me and Ray. We get all kinds of broads that would sleep with you.
Yeah.
And we wear a lot of, like, big condoms. You have to have special made condoms.
Just the runoff, you know, from being around our manly essence. All the women are hot anyway.
30 years old, no sex. You should have forearms like Popeye. me and Ray have huge forearms. Much bigger than yours. And we're with broads all the time. Well, anyway, we'll see you later.
Fred's head is exploding, isn't it, Fred? You don't know
He's
who to
like,
pick.
He's like, you know, you're going to make him wait for this date now.
At this point, you don't know who to pick, right?
Oh, no, but so far, the first duet sounds great.
Number one sounds great?
Yeah, both of them does.
Let's go to Bachelorette number three.
Okay.
Number three, is that you? Yeah. I seem having trouble hearing her. It's a can of music. Is that you, Cindy?
Yeah.
God, it's hard to hear you.
Hi, Howard. Hi, Fred.
Hiya.
I got you.
Are you at the ocean?
Yeah, I got your volume cranked all the way.
No, I'm not at the ocean.
You don't have someone else on the line with you, do you?
No.
Cindy, you're 22 years old. You're a student. What do you major in?
Well, right now I'm a graduate student in social science.
Social science? Well, what the hell do
you
get
never
when you...
want a job, do
yeah,
you?
Yeah, she just wants to go to school the rest of her life.
That's it.
And what do you mean a graduate student in social science? What are you going to do with that?
Not really sure, but... Howard, do you know who Fred sounds like?
Who?
That guy on A Fish Called Wanda.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, the stuttering guy?
Yeah.
Yeah.
when Rhonda kisses him and he can talk perfectly.
Yeah, well, maybe that'll happen with you guys.
Ah, she's thinking of being his little princess. You know, she'll kiss him and all of a sudden.
Yeah, don't count on it, honey. All right, now, Cindy, you hear Fred, of course. He sounds a little different.
Yeah.
And, I don't know, but I tell you, when you look at him, he's just a nice-looking guy.
Well, you said he looks a lot like you, or he's just as good-looking as you.
Absolutely.
You are quite a guy, so.
Well, he doesn't have Howard's long mane of hair.
Yeah, but
or
he's got
the biker jackets.
Yeah, but you could dress him up.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure if you sleep with Fred, he'll wear whatever you want.
Okay.
Now, the other girls have made promises here. Now, I don't know if they're going to keep them, but I know that number two would. They've made promises to actually sleep with Fred. Sight unseen. Now, would you go as far to do that?
Yes.
You would?
Mm-hmm. As a matter of fact, you were saying about Jeanette, number one, if she had a friend. And I have a friend who would definitely be interested two-on-one. That's like our sexual fantasy to dominate a guy.
Really? Yeah? Well, we just hit a jackpot.
Whoa!
Now, Cindy, all I know is I speak normally. I can't get girls to call in for me like this. Now, Cindy, in other words, what you're saying is, you and one of your college girlfriends like to have one guy at the same time?
That's right.
And you've done this already?
Well, we've tried, but it never quite worked out.
Now, how could that have happened?
Well, I don't know. A lot of times we just talk about it, and
you've never actually gotten a guy in the room with you.
I mean, you and this girl are alone, and you start talking about being with some other guy?
Yeah.
And are you girls undressed when you have these conversations?
No, we're not lesbians. None of that stuff.
I see. Oh,
so what do you look like? Did we determine that?
Yeah.
5'9".
5'9".
I weigh about 135 pounds.
Yeah.
And
you look like anybody famous?
Well, when I was younger, everybody said I looked a lot like Brooke Shields, but I never thought so.
I see. Well, that's not bad. So you're 5'9", 130 pounds, which is good. What about your cup size? Is it very big?
No, I'm like average, 30-60.
C is not average.
I'm not protruding or anything. So.
Well, that sounds nice to me, though.
Okay.
It sounds good. And you don't sound fat or anything. You probably have a very good body.
No, I'm not fat.
Would you two girls kiss each other all over to get Fred warmed up a little bit?
We'll kiss Fred all over.
I see, but not each other.
No, I'm not into that.
You're not into that. Well, it sounds to me like you've had some wild sexual experiences.
She said she
wasn't that experienced.
Yeah, but all of a sudden she's got friends who are willing to jump into bed with Fred here.
They're looking for them.
That's a healthy sexual attitude, let's put it that way.
I see. And you want to dominate Fred?
Yeah.
What does that mean? You're not going to hurt him, are you?
No, not at all. We're very gentle, but he sounds like, you know.
You're prepared to wear that bush gun yet. I hear domination. I'm thinking
head
of nuts
bar. Get your legs broken with an exercise bar.
Yeah, well, that's not bad. So, you're telling me that, at what age did you lose your virginity?
I guess it was about 19, and it was like a quickie kind of thing.
I see. You're just anxious to get it over with.
Yeah.
Or he was anxious to get it over with.
Yeah, that's it.
I see. And you haven't been in a real good relationship?
No, not really.
I see. Men just kind of abuse you?
No, I don't let them abuse me. That's why.
I see.
I don't like guys who think they're Mr. Macho Rambo kind of thing.
Oh, I see. So Fred sounds like a gentle guy.
Yeah.
You like that?
Yeah.
I see. So you're saying that on this date, you would meet Fred, take him back to your apartment, and you and your friend would be with him?
That's right.
Now, let me ask you something.
Fred, his lips are shaking. Easy, Fred.
You wouldn't be embarrassed to take Fred to a party with your friends?
No, that's a good point. Now, you know, Fred with the speech thing, you might, you know, everyone will be looking and going, well, what's wrong with this guy?
No, but, like, myself and my friend were very outgoing people, and I think Fred would fit right in. We're really wild, we're crazy. We have really excellent friends, so.
I see. You have excellent parties?
Yeah.
Now, what happens at these parties? Have you ever taken your clothes off in public?
Yeah, after a few drinks, I'm able to do anything, but.
Really? Now, what happened here? Tell me about that. You had a few drinks at a party one night?
Well, just recently, yeah. I was on vacation, and, you know, after a few drinks, I get kind of wild and loose, and, you know.
You're on vacation, and what?
I'm not, like, number one or two, let's put it that way. I'm not a go-go dancer.
I think you have potential, though.
Yeah, I think you could be a go-go dancer. You sound like you got all the right requirements.
I don't know about
a couple
that.
Of drinks and you're close. Now, what happened? You were at a party, you said?
Yeah.
And, like, what, a bunch of guys and girls were sitting around, and you had a few drinks, and what happened?
Well, so, like, we're all very friendly and open with each other, so it's not that shocking that something like that would happen.
You mean, but I don't understand. Like, all of a sudden, you get drunk and everyone, and you just went, oh, I got to take my clothes off?
Well, you know, you start getting hot. hot and everything.
Yeah, you get excited.
One piece comes off.
Now, who suggests this? Who?
No, it just happens.
You just sort of climb out of your clothes when you get drunk.
Exactly.
And all the other girls are doing this, too?
Yeah, girls. Guys.
And the guys all think
they're doing it, too?
Yeah.
And nothing sexual happens?
Well, you know.
Where is this party? No.
And how do I get invited?
All right, Robin, I'll send you.
And Fred can come to these parties as well?
Yeah. Howard, you are like my ultimate sexual fantasy.
Are you serious?
Yes. I've been listening to you for how long? Every day on the way to school, I turn you on. And so many times I miss class because I'm just sitting in my car and, you know,
anyway,
I can't get out.
I got to get divorced.
You know, it's fascinating to me the effect alcohol has on people.
Yeah, I know. Let's get back to the party. Never mind, you know.
Okay. What about the party, Howard?
Yeah, I'm so bored with you women who say you're attracted to me because, believe me, I couldn't find any of you when I was single. Believe me, I couldn't find you.
Yeah.
I was like Fred.
When you were like Fred.
Yeah, I was like, oh, come on, let's have a drink. But the point is that you're at the party.
You know, I drink and nothing happens.
You know, you go to sleep.
Yeah,
but all right, so you're sitting around drinking. Everyone's having a good time. The guys start slipping off their clothes, and the girls start slipping off their clothes.
Uh-huh.
And then all of a sudden, what happens? Everyone just starts kissing?
Sort of like that. You usually pair off, and, you know.
I thought you said you weren't that sexually experienced.
Well, I'm not. It's just that...
not that many parties.
Not one person.
So we get to about a party a month. All of a sudden, there might be many guys who you're with at this party. Like all of a sudden, right?
It happened occasionally.
Has anybody at this party heard of AIDS?
Well, we all know each other, so we know.
Yeah,
that.
You know, college students don't think that they're going to get AIDS.
Well, you know, they can put a little punch bowl in the middle of the room with the condoms in it, please.
Well, they do, Robin.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah, we have those dispensers all over campus.
They have a dispenser at the party.
Yeah.
A Pez dispenser.
Coin
filled with condoms. So it's yes, of course you all practice safe sex.
That's right.
You're right.
Right.
And college students don't think they're going to get AIDS because everybody knows each other.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. They know each other.
And then like everyone's making love to each other at these parties. So how many guys would you have been with in one night?
Well, the most is probably three.
Three, huh? Well, that's
but not all the way. You know, just fooling around.
And I see.
The last one.
I got to get a date with you. This is some. So where are you when we play Naked Jeopardy?
Oh, I tried to call before. I never got through.
Boy, this is going to be a tough decision for old Fred here.
What are you going to do?
All right, Fred, just hold on. I'm going to put you on hold, okay?
Okay.
Is there anything you want to say lovingly to Fred?
Fred, it'll be a date you never forget.
Oh my goodness.
He sounds so cute right now.
Yes, yes, he's cute. He's cute. He is.
Okay.
I'm selling you, Fred. All right. Hold on.
Okay.
That's Cindy.
Boy, oh boy, Cindy.
Master's
You're
in sociology.
Surprised.
What do you plan to do with that master's?
Yeah. I'm not
sex therapy.
What?
I'm going to take a long vacation when school's over, and then we'll decide what...
Because I can get a plan a little better.
Yeah.
Sociology, you can't get a job in that.
Well...
I don't see any listings in the New York Times for a sociologist.
Maybe I'll
looking for sociologists.
K-Rock.
Sorry, what?
Intern at K-Rock, any positions open?
An intern. Master's with it was interning.
Yeah, that's a very high-paid position.
Funny thing is, Cindy, I think we might hire you. All right, hold on.
Okay.
All right. Well, there she is. Three great girls. We got to take a break.
I went through college the wrong way, obviously.
Evidently. All right. Now it's time. I'm not going to say anymore. I think it's up to Fred.
He definitely has some definite feelings about this.
I think I know who I would choose, but I don't think I should say it.
All right. Until after, because I'd like to know who you would choose.
Okay.
Now,
I want you to do me a favor, Robin. I want you to write down who you think I would choose.
All right. Here we go. Okay, I'm going to write down who I think Fred should choose, too.
Yeah.
And would choose, too, and I'll tell you afterwards.
I know who Fred should choose, and I know who I would choose.
Yeah. All right.
Go ahead, Fred. Now, let us in on your reasoning. Here it is.
I think I prefer...
Don't talk too fast, Fred. Make sure you're definite.
I am definite number three.
Number three.
Oh, my goodness.
Wow, number three. Now...
I'm shocked.
All right, let's... Let's break the news to the other girls. I'm shocked. We do have some good consolation prizes. Number one, it's hard to believe, isn't it?
Again, you lost out on a good man.
I'm sorry.
Right.
I'm
hope
sorry.
I have a good time.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much.
I feel bad.
Yeah, me too.
I liked you a lot.
Yeah. I thought you would pick her, Howard.
How much do you like me, Howard?
I would have picked number three, Robin. It's funny you say
really?
That.
Really?
Yeah.
You would have picked number three?
Yeah.
I thought you would have picked number one.
Oh.
Although number one... You know, I think I would have I think our head would have exploded, much like Fred's. Now that you're saying number one, you know, number one, you're cute.
Yeah.
You got a good body. You guaranteed him sex. You're a go-go dancer.
Yeah.
And lots of experience.
Yeah.
Right.
How are you feeling right now, lady? Rejected by a mumbler.
Hey.
Have a nice weekend, you know? Hold
hey,
on.
Fred, have a good time, buddy.
Yeah, thank you.
You made a wise choice.
Okay, thank
why,
you.
Why did he make a wise choice?
Go for that young meat.
All right, hold on. Go for that young meat. I love a girl who's honest.
Yes, she is.
Celeste,
I thought, I'm going to tell you what I thought. I thought that he should have chosen you.
I thought he was going to. Yeah. I wrote his name down next to Celeste.
Yes.
I thought he was going to choose
Celeste
her.
Was a
well,
sure
I so
thing.
I thought so, too, because I've already done all the things that the other girls are going to do.
Yeah. You've had everything. You've even had two girls.
Yeah.
You've had it all.
Have. Well, you'll have to call him for Dial It Again. We'll hear that story.
I want to know that story.
Yeah, so Celeste.
That's okay, Fred. I hope you have a good time.
Thank you.
I can never tell if Fred's talking dirty or not. Sorry, Celeste, sounded kind of obscene. But, Fred told me he was worried that there's graffiti on your thighs if there were so many men.
But, no.
All right, hold on.
Okay.
Number three, you won.
Oh, great.
Now, listen, don't disappoint him.
I'm not going to disappoint him.
I'm going to call you after this date. I want to know what goes on.
Oh, every detail.
All right.
I don't believe any of this stuff is going to happen. I think this girl is lying.
Robin, if you'd like to, you can come along with your video camera.
Well, I might just think that's a good idea. Now, do me a favor. You two videotape yourselves so we can see.
Uh-huh.
And also, audio tape yourselves.
Okay. When is this date going to be?
When is the date going to be? I don't even know.
You'll be a year older.
Yeah. You might be as old as Celeste.
I'll be dragging my foot.
You'll be dragging your foot. That's good. It'll be, I think this one actually is going to go down soon because we've built up enough dial a date so we can take them all out.
I hope so, because Fred can't wait.
Before the new year,
I'm sorry, what?
Before the new year?
Yeah.
Okay.
It should be before the new year. All right, hold on. Well, this is great. You got your girl. I think it's going to work out well. She's kind of wild. I like number three. Number three is the one I would have chosen for myself.
Yes?
Yeah.
That's the problem.
Sure.
Yeah, I know.
You know, it seems like she's pretty wild for you, which might get in his way. You
know, so. I don't know. Let's see what happens. She claims that he's going to have a great time. He's going to lose his virginity.
But if she's that crazy about you, she just might go that wild with him to impress you. You know what I mean?
Well, for whatever reason, who cares?
You don't care.
Look at him. He's like, yeah, go ahead. I don't care.
He doesn't care what the motivation is. Right.
Jackie's worried about motivation. I'm worried about getting this guy in bed with a woman. Well, Fred, I hope your dream comes true. I know part of your dream came true today.
That's right.
You'll be thinking about that tonight, right?
Yeah, I will. I can hardly wait to meet her.
Yes, whatever.
Yeah.
The hell did he say, Robin?
I don't know.
I can hardly something.
Wait to meet her.
Oh, to meet her. Okay. So. And also, you'll be thinking about those two girls you met today. Will you be thinking about them tonight?
That's enough. I will believe me.
Is your bedroom close to your mother's bedroom?
No.
So you have some privacy tonight to think about those two girls?
Believe me,
yes. Fred told me off the air that he's going to go to the restaurant now where the dial-a-date is going to take place, so he can wait.
He doesn't want to miss it.
Right. He just doesn't want to be late or anything. So he will be there. So he'll be camped out. They have a special table for you.
Well, I certainly hope this girl lives up to her word.
Fred, good luck to you, pal.
Okay. Thank you, Howard. Thank you for everything.
Get up off your knees. You don't have... He's not a God.
You don't have to pray to me, Fred. That's a little sick. For God's sake, I just got your girl. That's all. Okay. If there's an express line to hell, I know we're on it.